Hello, fellow YouTubers. This is Derek Ducktape here. And first of all, I'd like to thank you for going on my channel and watching my videos. And thank you for watching this one. Today, I'm going to continue my series on lessons we can learn by remembering the Alamo. As this whole 2 weeks is the anniversary date of the siege that happened in San Antonio, Texas, where defenders led by William Baird Travis, David Crockett, and Jim Bowie all faced overwhelmed army of Mexican soldiers led by Antonio Lopez de Santa Anna, or we call him Santa Anna for short. So I'm going to take one part of what happened. William Barrett Travis drew out his sword, and he did this the night before the final assault, where all of them lost their lives, gave their lives for liberty of Texas. But William Barrett Travis, the night before, drew out his sword. He told the news that no one's going to help him. They're all alone. And he drew his sword across the sand, saying that if we stay here, very likely we're all going to die. If you're willing to accept this, face this, cross the line. So cross the line, you're going to stand with me, And that's what they did. Every one of them supposedly crossed the line. And some say David Crockett hesitated, because everyone knew, and he knew he was an icon, even at that time. So many plays, stuff like that, at that time, were made about him. And we have so many movies about him, too, about David Crockett. We call him, he wanted to be called David, not Davy, but the movies referred to him as Davy Crockett. Some say he was planning to stay there to fight to death, but the reason why he didn't cross the line at first, because he wanted all the men to decide for themselves. He didn't want anybody to just do it to follow him. So when William Barrett Travis drew out a sword, he's telling everybody, hey, look, this is time to face your fears. We all have fears. But keep going. So when he did that, shortly afterwards, just a few hours, Santa Anna ordered all his troops to go into the Alamo, siege it, get through, and have every one of them killed. And that's what happened. But they didn't let the fear of death stop them from what doing was right. And I'm going to shift gears a minute and talk to you about us Christians. And sometimes we are to face our fears. Yep, that's a sad thing. We all are called to face our fears. That's a commandment of God. And a lot of people do have fears, and yes, a lot of these fears are legit. But I'll show you what God's Word says about it. First, I'm going to Joshua 1:9. Joshua 9, have I not commanded thee, be strong and of good courage, be not afraid, neither thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee wherever thou go. And let's go to Isaiah 41:10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yes, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Another popular verse in Romans 8:38 and 39. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, neither height nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus. The last one is 2 Timothy 1:7. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. You know, I can give it all examples in the Bible where God has called a lot of people to face their fears. Like what the men of the Alamo did. They definitely had fear. I'm sure they had fear knowing what was going to happen. But they still stood their ground. They did it for the cause of liberty. And even today, we got young men and women serving our armed forces. I'm sure they have fear too. But they know they're in it for a cause, willing to lay down their lives necessary to keep us safe. We also have police officers, first responders as well. They lay down their lives, give their lives. But what are you afraid of? Is a question that I like to ask. What are you afraid of? The thing is, like I said, fear does no good. Fear is of the enemy. Courage is of God. Like I said, we're all human. We all have emotions. And some of these fears that people do have are legit. Definitely legit fears. So no one can really blame you for having these fears. But what are you going to do with that fear? Are you going to allow yourself to not do anything? Just try not to impact people because of a fear? Or are you going to use that fear as a motivation to face it? Make a difference in somebody's life. So, like those men at the Alamo, eventually, them facing their fear of going up against numbers like 30, 35 to 1. No way you can overtake those odds, and that's going to overtake you eventually. But they stand firm. They allow themselves to even give up their lives, cost them their lives, for freedom of Texas. So what are you willing to give up? What kind of fears are you willing to face? Whatever cause you have, and what are you willing to have it cost you? So I'm going to encourage you that just if you do have fear, give it to the Lord. And He'll take care of that fear for you. He'll give you the courage to do what you need to do. So, I'd like to thank you for watching this video. So, this is Derek Duct Tape here. See you later.